Hey, what's going on, guys? It's your boy Blue Dave back with another prize possession video. Now, I know I said in the last video, like, I want to surprise you guys with, like, as soon as I get this other Blu-ray in the mail soon, then, obviously I gotta review it first, and then I want to make that episode will have two Blu-rays, right? I want you guys to guess, alright? But I want to make that kind of like the finale of that mini-series. And I'll do, like, a ranking video on, like, the stuff that I've reviewed about, like, prize possessions. Yeah, so that'll be cool. So this is going to be episode 9, because, like I said, I want number 10 to be special. So today, here I have another Blu-ray that's regarding DC. And ever since the beginning of my channel, I will still, like, always defend this movie no matter what. No matter what anybody thinks about this movie, it's still a 10 out of 10 for me, and just because, like, as a genuine DC fan, like, you know, you can like or hate anything DC that you want, right? Like, if you're a hardcore fan or a casual fan, like, everyone's entitled to their own opinions, right? Especially when it comes to franchises like this. But please do not get pissed off when I talk about this specific movie, because it holds a special place in my heart, and this is a movie I've always wanted ever since I've heard about its release years ago. So I'm just going to get this out of the way. So here I have Ryan Reynolds' Green Lantern, the extended cut on Blu-ray. This is the original 2011 release. Although I did switch out the case because I'm trying to track down like another green case for this, but until then I have like this spare clear translucent case. I remember when I first heard about this movie, I even have the poster. If you've seen previous videos, you know I have the poster. I got the ring too, and I got a Green Lantern shirt. Like, I want to show off my Green Lantern merch. Like, you guys have no idea how much this character means to me. Like, he's like my all-time favorite DC character. And something about Ryan Reynolds' performance as Green Lantern. Okay, now one of my regular customers at my work, I don't know if he's still watching the channel, but, like, he brought up something about Ryan Reynolds. Okay, now, what I like about my actors is that I like it how they can, obviously, like, as the general, what do you call it? Like, the standard audience, whatever. Like, you expect your favorite actors to act differently, okay? Like, I don't know why some people want Ryan Reynolds to play the same character, if you will, in the movies that he's done, because whenever he's doing, like, a comedy movie, he makes fun of himself. Like, don't sell yourself short, as they say. Like, why would you become an actor then if you're gonna diss yourself? Like, do you really have that low self-esteem? Like, I am not a huge Ryan Reynolds fan, guys, because I don't like it when these, like, actors like him, for example, like, they're always in these, like, especially, like, rated R movies a lot, like, like, especially if it's, like, comedy or whatever, stupid humor. I know I'm gonna get complaints in the comments, like, well, that's kind of the point. They're born for these roles. Like, that's why I hate Deadpool the most. But, again, the only reason I'm interested in Deadpool 3 is because it's being made by Disney, not Fox, and it's gonna be a Marvel Studios film. So I wonder how they're gonna work into that. But anyways, I like my actors when they play different characters. Like some people were complaining, like, oh, he's trying to be, like, so serious and all that. Like, that's kind of the point for Hal Jordan's character. Like, even in the comics and, like, some other adaptations of Hal Jordan, like, he's a little comedic here and there. So this works for Ryan Reynolds. And the extended cut makes it so much better. And I definitely think that this movie deserves a 4K release. And it's funny, over the years, Ryan Reynolds has dissed this movie, even though he's never seen it. But last year, like, St. Patrick's Day, when he was promoting his, like, new gin, like, it's green. And he has the real Green Lantern ring, like, the prop. And he recorded himself watching it. Like, I'm surprised he didn't even get copyright struck. But then again, it's his movie anyway, so. Again, people like him, like, people like him bring a movie like this, like, back to, like, what do you call it? Like, get the excitement back. That's what I love about franchises. Like, if you have a celebrity or something like that, like, they hype this stuff up again. Like, this shows, like, he loves the movie now. And without this movie, him and Blake Lively, they wouldn't be a couple now. Like, I just don't see Ryan Reynolds and Scarlett Johansson being a married couple. Like, I was unaware of that until I found out about this movie and, like, behind the scenes. Like, I was hoping for a Green Lantern 2, and fun fact, this movie was supposed to start the DCEU. Like, Man of Steel, like, sure, that one started the DCEU, but this one, oh my gosh, can you imagine? There were rumors growing around, like, he was going to be in the Snyder Cut, but, like, can you imagine if they brought him back? But I'm sure Zach would have, like, a different adaptation for him. Like, kind of like Charlie Cox, you know. Either way, I am happy with this film. I am grateful that we have a film like this. I'm not sure if there's... Well, I was going to say, like, I don't know if there's one bad thing I would say about this, but, like, not the main villain, Parallax, but, like, the other villain who's, like, the son of the senator. Forgive me if I don't mention his name, but, like, oh my gosh, he was just so bad. That's why Parallax just came in and, like, ended him. But, like, Sinestro, though, I wanted to see him more in the yellow suit. Like, that mid-credits scene, oh my gosh. But I want to hear your honest opinions in the comments, guys. What do you think of this movie personally, okay? Did you have high hopes for this movie when this came out? Because, let's just keep the comments nice, okay, guys? Because we're trying to keep this a nice community and all that. But just let me know in the comments what do you think of this movie. And Warner Brothers and DC, if you're watching, please re-release this as a 4K release. I remember I wanted to get the 3D release. So yeah, if you're ever going to watch this movie for the first time, watch the extended cut. And it's only on the Blu-ray, but like, but you can also own it digitally too, so, and that's what I have. So, alright, I'm going to sign off now. So thank you so much for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. Please turn the post notification bell to share my content if you haven't already. And again, what do you think of this movie personally, guys? Okay, I want to hear your opinions, okay? Again, let's be nice, okay? Alright, again, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks for having me. The Lord be with you guys, always love you guys. Peace out, guys, and you guys have a great night. Alright, thank you. Thanks again so much for watching, guys. Bye.